Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Glory be to the Father, to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. O my Jesus, save us from the fire of hell. Lead all souls to heaven, especially those in the most need of thy mercy. The second glorious mystery, the Ascension.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, a world without end. Amen. O my Jesus, forgive us our sins, save us from the fires of hell, and lead all souls to heaven, especially those in most need of thy mercy. The third glorious mystery is the descent of the Holy Spirit.
Thank you.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Glory be to the Father, to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. Now and ever shall be. O my Jesus, forgive us our sins. Save us from the fire of hell. Lead all souls to heaven, especially those in the most need of thy mercy. The fourth glorious mystery, the Assumption.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, a world without end. Amen. O my Jesus, forgive us our sins, save us from the fires of hell, and lead all souls to heaven, especially those in most need of thy mercy. The fifth glorious mystery is the crowning of the Blessed Mother as Queen of Heaven and Earth.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day, forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Glory be to the Father, to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. O my Jesus, forgive us our sins, save us from the fire of hell, lead all souls to heaven, especially those in the most need of thy mercy. Hail, Holy Queen, Mother of Mercy, hail our life, our sweetness, and our hope. To thee do we cry, poor banished children of Eve. To thee do we send up our sighs, our mourning, our weeping in this valley of tears. Turn then, most gracious advocate, thy eyes of mercy towards us. And after this, our exile, show unto us the blessed fruit of thy womb, Jesus. O clement, O loving, O sweet Virgin Mary, pray for us, O Holy Mother of God, that we may be. O God, begotten Son, by his life, death, and resurrection, has purchased for us the rewards of eternal salvation. Grant, we beseech thee, that we receive Holy Rosary of the Blessed Virgin Mary, may both imitate what they contain and obtain what they promise through the same Christ our Lord. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
And now I invite Julie to come and do the eulogy. Dear friends and family, I am so honored to be here to celebrate the life of Corey. He was my nephew and someone who played a special role in our family's lives. Life has a way of taking us on a journey of our own to find ourselves and experience it to the fullest. That's how it is. A family bond never diminishes, and we show up for each other when it matters most. That was Corey. Him showing up for us, and now us showing up for him. He was well loved by his family and friends. Most people would say he was a kind, gentle soul, always respectful and willing to lend a hand. It was just his nature. From a young age, Corey was curious. His mom, Monica, would buy him various toys or electronics, and not too long after, walk in on him and he would be taking them apart just to put them back together. Well, maybe put them back together. Because a lot of the time he'd get bored with it and leave it unfinished. That's something that never changed about him.
always trying to figure out the how and why. Corey loved to cook a good steak meal with a Pepsi and some vanilla ice cream, or a Rice Krispie treat was his to go. Now, anytime we see a jar of minced garlic, it will bring back memories of him because that was his thing. You can never have too much garlic, he'd say. In the morning, it was fried eggs. His nephews would tell you his eggs were the best because he made them just right. All of the little things we miss and may pop up throughout the day that remind us of him, but so very grateful for the time we had. Corey was a simple man and never really made a fuss about things, just went with the flow. So let us not dwell on his passing, but celebrate his life, the love he gave, and the lessons he taught us. His shy little smile and his comforting hugs. I know he's smiling down on us now because he is finally free and at peace.
It's already back there.
Just a closer walk with thee. Granted, Jesus is my plea. Daily walking close to thee, let it be, dear Lord, let it be. I am weak, but thou art strong. Jesus, keep me from all wrong. I'll be satisfied as long as I walk. Let me walk close to thee. When my feeble life is over, time for me will be no more. Woe that bright eternal shore, I will walk, dear Lord, close to thee.
Again, welcome to Sacred Heart Church. Please stand and turn towards the entrance of the church, the baptismal font, while we begin the Mass proper. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. The waters of baptism. Corey died and rose with Christ. May he now share with him eternal glory. Okay. You come in at the last with Corey. Okay.
Amazing grace, how sweet the sound that saved and set me free. I once was lost, but now I'm found. Was blind, but now I see. Grace that taught my heart to fear, and grace my fears relieved. His grace that brought me saved thus far, and grace will amazing grace, how sweet the sound that has saved and set me free. I once was lost, but now I'm found. Was blind, but now I see.
Let us pray. Show us, Lord, the immense power of your goodness, that as we weep for our brother Corey Don, taken from us by a sudden death, we may be confident that he is passed over into your eternal company. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever. Amen. I invite you to be seated as our readers come forward.
A reading from the book of Lamentations. My soul is deprived of peace. I have forgotten what happiness is. I tell my future is lost, all that I hope for from the Lord. The thought of my homeless poverty is wormwood and gall. Remembering it over and over leaves my soul downcast within me. But I will call this to mind as my reason to have hope. The favors of the Lord are not exhausted. His mercies are not spent. They are received each morning, so grace is his faithfulness. My portion is the Lord, says my soul. Therefore will I hope in him. Good is the Lord to one who waits for him, to the soul that seeks him. It is good to hope in silence for the saving help of the Lord. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord, he will be my shepherd, nothing more shall I want. all I want. In valleys of green, he lets me lie. To restful waters, he leads me. If ever I walk in darkness, nothing more would I fear. My foes, and over my head you pour your oil. My cup is flowing over. Your love will be always with me every day of my life. My home will I shall live. The Lord, he will be my shepherd. Nothing more shall I want. He leads me along the path of right, according to his word.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, no one lives for oneself, and no one dies for oneself. For if we live, we live for the Lord. And if we die, we die for the Lord. So then whether we live or die, we are the Lord's. For this is why Christ died and came to life, that he might be Lord of both the dead and the living. Why then do you judge your brother? Or you, why do you look down on your brother? For we shall all stand before the judgment seat of God. For it is written, as I live, says the Lord, every knee shall bend before me, and every tongue shall give praise to God. So then each of us shall give an accounting of himself to God. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Alleluia, 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 gloria al Señor. Alleluia, 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 gloria al Señor. I am the resurrection and the life, said the Lord.
The Lord be with you.
With your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory be to you, Lord.
When Jesus arrived in Bethany, he found that Lazarus had already been in the tomb for 4 days. Now Bethany was near Jerusalem, only about 2 miles away. Many of the Jews had come to Martha and Mary to comfort them about their brother. When Martha heard that Jesus was coming, she went to meet him, but Mary sat at home. Martha said to Jesus, "Lord, if you had been here, my brother would not have died. But even now I know that whatever you ask of God, God will give you. Jesus said to her, "Your brother will rise." Martha said to him, "I know he will rise in the resurrection on the last day." Jesus told her, "I am the resurrection and the life. He who believes in me, even if he dies, will live. And he who lives and believes in me will never die. Do you believe this?" She said to him, "Yes, Lord. I have come to believe that you are the Christ, the Son of God, the one who is coming into the world." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise be to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
The family here at Sacred Heart has heard me talk about the Holy Land often. I had the privilege of living, praying, studying, and traveling throughout the Holy Land twice in my life. First time I was a senior in college, it was my final semester of college as an undergraduate. It was in the spring of 1986. We stayed at the Ecumenical Institute of Tantur, which was owned by the University of Notre Dame, my undergraduate alma mater. And it was a small group of eight of us from Notre Dame. For 3 weeks, we had a group of 50 from Eastern Mennonite University with us. That was fun, because we were all males, and they were mostly girls, so that was good. And then the second time in my life, I was a third-year theologian and studying seminary at the University of St. Thomas in Minnesota, the School of Divinity, in preparation for priesthood. And there was a small group, again, eight men, one priest. There we stayed in the Old City. I was right next to the Church of the Holy Sepulchre. And both times we took many field trips to get to know the Holy Land, the sacred places where Jesus taught, where he died and rose from the dead. So when I look back at those experiences, I thought about the second time that I was there, and I had an adventurous friend, Tony Hess, now Father Tony Hess, and he and I went exploring for Bethany, the place we mentioned in today's gospel. We went to find Bethany. So as scripture tells us, it's only a short distance from Jerusalem. So you come over the Mount of Olives, through the Kidron Valley. You leave the city of Jerusalem through the Kidron Valley into the Mount of Olives. And on the backside is Bethany. We had a hard time finding it. You know, I thought it was a Holy Land expert because of my time there before, but we searched for an hour and a half, and we finally found Bethany. But there's really no town, there's no village today. Bethany is what we would call here in the Wild West, the Old West, a ghost town. There's nothing or no one in Bethany. It's just nothing. There's old buildings, and that's that. The reason we wanted to find Bethany was because it was Jesus's home away from home. Whenever Jesus, Mary, and Joseph, the Holy Family, traveled to the Holy Land, they stayed in Bethany, probably with Lazarus's parents, with Martha and Mary's parents. So when Jesus made pilgrimage later in life after St. Joseph had died with the Blessed Virgin Mary, his 12 apostles, and then many disciples, probably looking at nearly 100 plus disciples, nearly 100 more disciples, they would stay in Bethany. They would stay with Lazarus, Martha, and Mary. So there was such a good friendship between Lazarus, Martha, and Mary. If you watch the series The Chosen, it says that it presents Lazarus as an old friend from Nazareth. He and Martha and Mary that are now in Bethany. So however they knew Lazarus, they were good friends. And so when Lazarus died, it was curious to the apostles and the other disciples that Jesus didn't leave immediately. Earlier in St. John's Gospel, he said that this death was for the glory of God. So the Jewish tradition was that after 3 days in the tomb, that the body would begin to decompose and it would smell. And my favorite account of that is in the King James Version of the Bible, it says, "He stinketh," when they were talking about Lazarus, who had been in the tomb now 4 days. "He stinketh." I think that's a great translation. But anyway, they were worried about Jesus going in there. And Jesus goes in and raises him from the dead. That's the gospel that comes after the gospel that immediately follows the gospel we heard this morning. So we know this story well. We always hear this story 2 weeks before Easter, then Palm Sunday, then Easter Sunday. So it's a text and a gospel that's very familiar to us. The raising of Lazarus from the dead, Jesus' good friend. And here, what we hear this morning is the intellectual part of this. First of all, Martha comes out and says, "If you had been here," Mary comes out and says, "If you had been here, he'd never died." And Jesus says, "Have you come to believe in me?" And she says, "Of course, I believe that you are the Messiah." And then the sister Martha comes, and reaffirms that Jesus says, "I am the resurrection and the life. Whoever believes in me will have eternal life." So Jesus is disclosing his identity to his good friends, and it's in the context of this death of Lazarus. And they had sent word to Jesus when he was sick, implicitly saying, "Jesus, come and you can save his life." And Jesus comes and he's already dead. So what's the point? The point is in St. John's Gospel, we have this high Christology, this high theology of Jesus Christ, and he is the Lord of life. And he is also the Lord of death. He has power over life, he has power over death. And so we heard in our second reading from the letter to the Romans, whether we live or die, we live for the Lord. That was true for his friend Lazarus. It's true for all of us. It's true for all the baptized. That's why we started at the baptismal font. We remember that Corey, who was baptized into the life of Christ. That's why we have this Paschal candle, to remember that Jesus claimed Corey when he was baptized. And through all the sacraments he received, he drew into a deeper communion with the Lord. And my brothers and sisters, that is the reality for all of us and for all the baptized. So if we think about this kind, gentle man, as we heard in the eulogy, it was reflected, I think, in his final days, in his final hours, in terms of the fact that it was Wednesday of Holy Week when he suffered this death that was so heartbreaking, because there was no chance to say goodbye. It was very sudden, which is why we prayed that prayer for those who die suddenly. It was in the midst of Holy Week, the Sunday between Palm Sunday, where we remember Jesus' passion and death, and the next Sunday, where we remember his resurrection. Jesus was 33, the tradition holds. Corey was 34, young, both of them. And all of that reminds us that it's the Christ event, his passion, death, and resurrection, or the Paschal Mystery, it's sometimes called, that really has its imprint on our whole lives, if we think about it. Because throughout our lives, we're called to die to self and to rise in Christ. You know, and it starts at the moment that we're conceived in the wombs of our mothers. Our mothers have to sacrifice for us for those 40 weeks before we're born. And then when we're born by the grace of God, the sacrifices begin. We give up sleep, we give up rest to care for our children. And that mothering, fathering relationship doesn't end. Continues all through life. I know that. My grandmother was in her mid-90s, and she would tell me, "Mijito, I have to take care of Mijita." That is her oldest daughter, who was sick. Grandmother was in better health. She was taking care of her oldest daughter in her 70s, while she was in her mid-90s. Doesn't care. It doesn't stop. It never ends. That's a relationship for life. And so that is the Paschal Mystery in a small way, in a loving way. And then the moment when we experience the end of our earthly life and we move towards heavenly life is mysterious in a sense. That's why they call it the Paschal Mystery. You know, we don't understand fully how the Heavenly Father will allow his Son to die. But Jesus willingly sacrificed his life for us. He prayed in the garden the night before, just before he was arrested, "Father, if it be possible, let this chalice pass me by. But not my will, but your will be done." So we know that no human person wants to suffer. In his human nature, Jesus wanted to avoid that suffering. In fact, he bled. He perspired blood because of the suffering that he knew he would endure. But he endured it out of love for us, to sacrifice his life for our lives. And in a particular way, as we remember Corey in this Mass of Christian burial, as we prayed for him before Mass in the Rosary, and as we'll lay his earthly remains to rest in our Alamosa Cemetery. So we keep that all together, knowing that the Paschal Mystery is the pattern of the mystery for our lives, our mystery for what happened, tragically, in one sense, in terms of his death, but in hope, in resurrection for him as well, during that Holy Week. And so we keep that in mind, especially for Monica and Tony, all the family and friends that are here, because it's a mystery that's hard for us to wrap our hands around, to wrap our head around, even though we know for over 2,000 years that Jesus rose from the dead, and he gave us a sure and certain hope of resurrection. And that's what we celebrate today, even though our hearts are heavy, because his life ended, we think, way too young. But none of us know the mind of God. None of us know fully the mystery of God and his love and his mercy. So we pray for those two realities to come together. The reality of resurrection, the reality of the mystery of his life, his death, in Jesus Christ. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. Amen. Brothers and sisters, Jesus Christ is risen from the dead and sits at the right hand of the Father, where he intercedes for his church, confident that God hears the voices of those who trust in the Lord Jesus. We join our prayers to his.
Our response is, hear our prayer. In baptism, Corey received the light of Christ. Scatter the darkness now and lead him over the waters of death. Lord, in your mercy, hear
our prayer.
Our brother Corey was nourished at the table of the Savior. Welcome him into the halls of the heavenly banquet. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Many friends and members of our families have gone before us and await the kingdom. Grant them an everlasting home with your Son. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Those who trusted in the Lord now sleep in the Lord. Give refreshment, rest and peace to all whose faith is known to you alone. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
The family and friends of Corey Don Fernandez seek comfort and consolation. Heal their pain and dispel the darkness and doubt that come from grief. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We are assembled here in faith and confidence to pray for our brother Corey. Strengthen our hope so that we may live in the expectation of your Son's coming. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer. Lord God, giver of peace and healer of souls, hear the prayers of the Redeemer Jesus Christ and the voices of your people, whose lives were purchased by the blood of the Lamb. Forgive the sins of all who sleep in Christ and grant them a place in the kingdom. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. I invite you to be seated as our altar is prepared.
Where the sadness ever Master, grant that I may never see, but you be consoled to console, but to understand, to be loved as to love with all my soul. Make me a channel of your peace. It is in pardoning that we are pardoned. Giving of ourselves that we receive, and dying that we're born to eternal
life. Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and the glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Be attentive, O Lord, to our prayers for your servant, Corey, whose massive Christian burial we celebrate today. And through this sacrifice of conciliation and praise, graciously add him to the company of your saints, through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For it is at your summons that we come to birth, by your will that we are governed, and at your command that we return on account of sin to that earth from which we came. And when you give the sign, we who have been redeemed by the death of your Son shall be raised up to the glory of his resurrection. And so with the company of angels and saints, we sing the hymn of your praise, as without end we acclaim.
Holy, 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 holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest, Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest, Hosanna in the highest.
I invite able-bodied Catholics to kneel. Everyone else may be seated, please. You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy, and you never cease to gather people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, By the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For in the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
By your cross and resurrection, you have set us free.
Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim, by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son, and filled with his Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse,
with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with Saint Therese of the Child Jesus, patroness of our diocese, San Cayetano, patron of the Theatine Order, and with all the saints on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May the sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Stephen, our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you've gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you've summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. Remember your servant, Corey Don, whom you've called from this world to yourself. Grant that he, who was united with your Son in a death like his, may also be one with him in his resurrection, when from the earth he will raise up in the flesh those who have died, and transform our lowly body after the pattern of his own glorious body. To our departed brothers and sisters too, and to all who are pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, when you will wipe away every tear from our eyes. For seeing you, our God, as you are, we shall be like you for all the ages, and praise you without end.
Through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen.
On this sacred altar, on this Eucharistic table, the fruits of Jesus' passion, death, and resurrection are represented. It's Christ himself on this altar who offers us his body, blood, soul, and divinity so that we may live a life of grace now and the eternal glory which Jesus gave us from Calvary, from the empty tomb. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope in the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant us peace and unity, in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let's offer each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God, who takes away the sins of the world,
Again, I invite able-bodied Catholics to kneel. Everyone else may be seated, please. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sin of the world.
Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. We await a Savior, the Lord Jesus Christ, who will change our mortal bodies to conform with his glorified body. Catholics who wish to receive communion can come forward to receive communion as they do each Sunday. If you wish to receive a blessing, just cross your hands like this, okay?
I, the Lord of sea and sky, I have heard my people cry. Dwell in dark and sin, my hand will save. I who made the stars of night, I will make their darkness bright. Who will bear my light to them? Whom shall their hearts of stone, help me give them. heart alone, I will speak my words to them. Whom shall I send? Here I am, Lord. Is it I, Lord? I have heard you calling in the night. I will go. Lord, prepare me to be a sanctuary, pure and holy, tried and true, with thanksgiving I'll be a living sanctuary. It is you, Lord, came to save the heart and soul of every man. It is you, Lord, who knows my weakness, who gives me strength with thine own hand. Lord, prepare me, be a sanctuary, pure and holy, tried and true. With thanksgiving, I'll be a living sanctuary for you. Lord, prepare me to be a sanctuary, pure and holy, tried and true. With thanksgiving, I'll be a living sanctuary for you.
Let us pray. Grant, we pray, Almighty God, that your servant Corey, who has journeyed from this world, may by this sacrifice be cleansed and freed from sin, and so receive the everlasting joys of the resurrection. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Trusting in God, we have prayed together for Corey, Don, and we now come to the last farewell. There is sadness in parting, but we take comfort in the hope that one day we shall see Corey again and enjoy his friendship. Although this congregation will disperse in sorrow, the mercy of God will gather us together again in the joy of his kingdom. Therefore, let us console one another in the faith of Jesus Christ.
Que los ángeles del cielo te encuentren y te lleven al paraíso del Señor. Los ángeles del cielo te encuentren y los santos y los mártires también. Que los ángeles en coro te reciban en la vida santa de Jerusalén. Y con Lázaro, pobre en esta vida, tengas el descanso eterno con Dios. Tengas el descanso eterno con Dios.
Let us pray. Into your hands, Father of mercies, we commend our brother Corey, in the sure and certain hope that together with all who have died in Christ, he will rise with him on the last day. We give you thanks for the blessings which you bestowed upon Corey in this life. They are signs to us of your goodness and of our fellowship with the saints in Christ. Merciful Lord, turn toward us and listen to our prayers. Open the gates of paradise to your servant, and help us who remain to comfort one another with assurances of faith, until we all meet in Christ and are with you and with our brother forever. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit come down upon you and remain with you forever.
Amen.
In peace, let us take our brother to his place of rest.
Thanks be to God.
Sing a new song unto the Lord. Let your song be sung from mountains high. Sing a new song unto the Lord. Sing it alleluia. Shout with gladness, dance for joy. Oh, come before the Lord and play for God on glad tambourines. Let your trumpet sound. Sing a new song unto the Lord. Let your song be sung from my